this video, I'm outside the Quarles campus, which was formerly Quarles Secondary School for Boys and Girls from 1955 to 1973, and I was a pupil in the second half of the 60s. So got permission from Havering Council to actually come in and have a look around the classrooms. Well, I've been told that the outlying buildings, workshops, are going to be closed. It's a bit of a shame, but we'll be going inside the buildings and have a look around. I'm with Peter Adams, he's an ex-pupil of Quarles as well. And we've got to do this before it's all knocked down. So this is part of history. I'm walking through here for the first time in 50 years. Right, this looks totally different. This is probably part of the new automatic. Yeah, so we're in the main entrance hall of the Quarles campus. As I say, it's totally changed from our day back in the late 60s, but quite expected it really. And yeah, we're on our way to the boys' school, and I think I can hear the alarm going for the registration. GoPro stopped recording. Yeah, so Peter reckons that George's office was about in this area here, and maybe that was Mrs. Stewart's office. She was the George's secretary, that's right. I'm looking forward to seeing a bit that I'll recognise.
This is the staff room.
Staff room. Never would have been in here, Peter. Do you reckon their original stair rails?
Yeah, original stairs.
So where would that have gone to in our day then?
He used to call the place called the Veranda.
I'd like to see that.
Was there, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Bonham, do you remember that?
Yeah, Bonham. Yeah. Can you have a look up there? Off of you. Mm. 50 years later. Yeah, now once I always remember McLaren's room, yeah? Because he used to get a real rough time with the kids, didn't he?
Poor it was sod.
Yeah, it was this one. I think it's definitely this one.
Yeah.
And
it was McLaren's, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I remember it was really badly treated by the kids, but I always remember George Laws, obviously knew. Yeah. And I used to sit here, right there. I used to sit right there, and you're always afraid that George's silhouette's going to turn up at that window, and it did, didn't it? Yeah, we treated him badly. I would
come in.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Then an hour later, he'd come down and he'd say, "What do you want?"
Did he? <Yeah. laughs> Oh, sorry, it must have happened to you then, right. this is the...
Bonham's veranda.
Veranda. That's the first time I come across the word veranda, and I still don't know what it means. But
this is an all. See, they've all been partitioned off. Look.
Yeah.
This is a normal classroom. That's the blackboard was there, wasn't it?
You said.
I think Miss Clayton had this one.
Oh, that name is. We used to call her Eddie because there used to be a footballer called Eddie Clayton. I remember that. And she was a little petite history teacher. Yeah,
fashion, you remember? Little fashion icon.
Yeah. I think I had geography with Mr. Court in that room. And I used to really enjoy geography. I remember sitting in the front row just about here, and I fell asleep during his lesson, and Mr. Court actually, I think he saw the funny side of it. It's deeply embarrassing.
Oh, right. It's all, that's okay. A proper wall.
Yeah. Okay. But I think, Mr. Evans' TD room is in this area anyway. Yeah, it's looking totally different. I only had the slipper once, And that's for getting me homework, Mr. Jeffries, but he was a great teacher. That's a bit, this is a bit of the veranda I remember, I'm sure. Probably gonna be the same, isn't it? Yeah, because I just remember seeing these glass bits. I'm sure it's on that side as well, but they've changed it all, haven't they? Oh, it looks. Yeah, it's all changed, isn't it?
It's
another view of Harold Hill. Yeah, so there's the famous gym, which unfortunately we can't go in, it's been locked off. But we're now going down to the first floor. I think on the left used to be the music teacher's room, Mr. Norris. Don't expect his piano's still there.
That was Norris's room.
Yeah, that's right.
This was Reynolds' room.
Ah, okay. I remember being in this room, but for a different lesson.
This is the only sort of thing I can remember, because it was the first week I was in with my form teacher.
There's the stairs we went down to at playtime into the playgrounds. These were probably manned by prefects. I never was a prefect, I was too small. the only time I remember coming in here, well, apart from putting the coat up in the morning and collecting it at night, is remember, it used to rain. We was allowed to come in, weren't we? We used to sit on the benches of the cloakroom, and it was mayhem. Oh, hang on. This is.
It's one of the old halls, isn't it?
Yeah. All right. Okay. Is this an assembly hall, do you reckon, then?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Mind you, come on. It's got to be bigger than this, isn't it? I think it. Yeah, so they've done some subdividing of the assembly hall as well.
That was one of the ways out of the assembly, do you remember?
Yeah. Yeah. I just, a memory I've got, I mean, this is just me. There used to be a special hymn. I don't know if you remember it. I mean, kids weren't interested in singing hymns, were they? But there was one hymn that everyone did. It's a big rousing chorus. It was called "Tell Me the Old Story." Do you remember it? And George really got a lot of pleasure out of seeing us belting it out.
Sign out, just have a little ball. Do we sign out when you go out the building? Yeah, we walk around that sign there.
Lovely, thank you.
That's the
girls are
singing with him.
Yeah. That looks like it's. Sorry?
Your light.
No light. Right. Yeah, so that's. We worked out that that's probably the old girls' assembly hall.
Yeah, it's got a low ceiling and it's totally changed. The only one what you can. The boys' one still looks half the same.
Yeah, they look like the original columns. We're going up to the girls' school now, and I think that was in 1964. They joined up. I did a little bit of research.
68.
Was it really? Where did I get 64 from then?
You weren't even here.
No, I weren't, was I? Oh, sorry. Yeah, of course. Because I was in the juniors. Yeah, so we think we're in George's new office when we moved to the Goose Girls School.
Yeah.
Deprive the ladies of not seeing their old school, although it's very much mirror image of boys. But we're now come to, what is this, like the, I don't know the cardinal points. This is, well, we're at the end of the girls' school, aren't we? And I remember,
it's east.
I know this one. Do you know this one? This is Mr. Lippman's. When we moved in with the girls, this is Mr. Lippman's class. And I can see him now rushing to the bus stop at lunchtime, as soon as the bell goes. I think we had Mrs. Wright for English Lit, and I think this might have been her...
The one above it used to be Tomlinson.
Yeah, I think you're right there, yeah. Yeah, so we're going up to the first floor of the girls' school. So you reckon this was Tomlinson, didn't you? I don't know, I get the feeling, the classroom seems quite big actually, to what I thought it was. No, so this is the original size. Oh, you remember, you used to have
stock rooms.
Did you?
No, not
really. Oh yeah.
Do you remember?
Yeah, geography, yeah. But let's just have a quick view outside. That's the, they changed the girls' gym into engineering workshops. It's all come back to me now. We're talking about the library. That was, if we imagine we're in the boys' school, it was like down like that, wasn't it? So I think it was in opposite the veranda, or in the veranda. So, although we were in the girls' school, yeah, this was a place where the library would have been, but again, they've got all these subdivisions up. Yeah, they look like the original
Red, yeah.
That's new, isn't it? That's part of that big superstructure in the middle, isn't it?
It's been a sixth form thing. Do you remember with the settees in it?
Yeah. Did you ever go to
the... They used to smoke in there, didn't they, the sixth form? Because they was considered...
They had privileges, yeah. Do you remember going to night school? Like the youth club school?
Yeah.
And I remember I used to... play table tennis, stuff like that, but yeah. I think it's that room we smoked in as well.
Remember?
George's parking space.
George used to park just there with his red MGB.
He had that, but didn't also, I don't know if before either, didn't he have a brown Rover? Do you remember that? Or am I thinking about another teacher? Should we go over to the workshop, playground? me and Peter still can't work out what these great big cylindrical things are. But all this bit here, the red brick, and that reception is all new, been added on. Bike sheds, here we come. Yeah, we're off to see the bike sheds. I'm sure I left five players number six behind the wall over there. I'll see if it's still there. Right, now what I remember, tell me if I'm wrong, Peter, our, that whatever it is, caretaker's lodge, is on top of the path to where we used to come in, is that right? Used to come in and walk up there. Wasn't it? Is that where the school gate was, wasn't it?
No, it was Cedis Extension on the left. It was down the side here, wasn't it? It was directly in front where we're standing.
Yeah.
That was a gate.
Alright.
This is that's the original Jones bungalow, isn't it?
Right. So this is the workshop. On the left was metalwork, Mr. Linley and Heffernan. And then on the other side was the woodworkers, I think it was Mr. Jeffries. Yeah, so saying that They're the old bike sheds. Not there anymore. And remember, that's the entrance that we used to go into for the metal workshop. Playground. And I remember down, this is where on a wet day when we couldn't play on the football pitch, we used to come down here to play football.
You remember when you was a first year, they used to threaten throwing you down the bank?
Yeah, vaguely remember that. Yeah. Well, it's all changed, isn't it?
Remember the pig in the corner, yeah?
Yeah. I tell you, I've got one little disturbing memory. And it was in metalwork one day. And I think there was a lady that ran the small holding. Anyway, she came in with a cut. I can't remember if they were geese or chickens. Came into the workshop, and one of the teachers, obviously they got an arrangement where he wrung their necks, you know, which is the way it was done.
Definitely.
That's right.
and the lady was Mrs. Moore.
That's it, Mrs. Yeah. Moore, yeah. Yeah, but as a like a 13-year-old, it was a bit of a shock, but at least an introduction to the ways of the countryside. Right, this is where I was most at home, playing football.
That was the last marker.
Yeah, so. Yeah, we got this ironwork all the way along for security. Sorry, Peter, this is staff room here, yeah?
Yeah,
that's the staff room.
The offices where Laws used to be.
Yeah, and George Law's office. So this is where the football pitch was. Probably at one stage, it was probably rugby as well. Because we had a few Welsh teachers, they were... Remember Jones, the biology teacher, he was into rugby.
Jeffries,
yeah. And then in the summer, they used to print out, whitewash a whole athletics track, didn't they?
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
Big full size.
Smallest golf field
in there. What, sorry?
It looks so small.
It does, doesn't it? And I don't know if you remember this, Peter, where we're going now, over the other side of those railings. You could do a little bit of canoeing. I never actually got the privilege of doing it, wasn't it? It was over there, wasn't it? Yeah. All right, so we come over to where cricket nets were. Weren't a fan of cricket, to be honest. But, yeah, so this is Quarles School.
This could be a gate here, couldn't it? Come and go, they used to have this gate open.
Yeah.
Because we used to go out with dinner times and that, for real.
Sorry, the prefix, yeah. Yeah, keep to the left. Yeah, I don't know, when the break time was finished, was it a bell or a whistle? Can't remember. But I just seem to remember, like...
Playground, yeah, that's how you do roofing, look.
Ah.
There was a bell in the playground. A whistle in the playground off the teachers.
Yeah.
But also the bell in the school, wasn't it?
About, you're saying about the white stone over the manor?
Yeah.
It looks a bit...
They recovered it in one of Rugby's history lessons and brought it back to the school.
Yeah.
And when I left in 71, it was still in the classroom.
Right. That must have taken a bit of muscle to get that back. Christ.
Half a dozen boys in a wheelbarrow.
Yeah. So I guess this being the girls' side, that would have been cookery, domestic science, wouldn't it? Bake that one there. There we are, ladies. That's where you bake your first cake.
It looks more original than ours.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? It looks a bit more untouched, doesn't it? And another playground, which I became a bit more familiar with in the latter days. And there's a car park. I was smoking with the boys upstairs.